What are the factors that affect how badly you can get injured in an arc flash event? Size of the explosion, proximity to the event, time exposed to the hazard, and the PPE you're wearing.
Let's start with the size of the explosion. From a raw calculation standpoint, the heat of an arc flash is a function of the amount of current over time. What this means is the heat from an arc flash event is determined by your available fault current and how long the arc is allowed to propagate.
Incident energy calculation yields a value on your equipment in calories per centimeter squared. This is a robust calculation based on the strength of your utility, impedance of upstream components, and how fast the protective devices interrupt the fault. Downstream regenerative items like large motors can also contribute to the event too. So that means if you abruptly remove power, the motor continues to spin, turning it into a generator for a short amount of time.
There are some ways we can control arc flash explosions with engineering and design. Arc flash mitigation reduces hazards and risks by modifying protective devices and electrical infrastructure. You can find out more in the inherent control section of the hierarchy of risk controls.
Before you attempt any modifications to upstream protective devices, make sure to get engineering approval, because it all plays a role in arc flash calculations. If you turn up breaker settings to troubleshoot or replace a fuse with a larger or different type of fuse, you can cause unexpected downstream hazards.
EBSCO, Electrical Power and Safety Company. Safety, diligence, collaboration.